O you, if what you have told me is truthful and you have not lied, then this man truly is a prophet.
وقد كنت أن أعلم أنه سيخرج في هذا الزمان.
And I know and I am aware that he has been prophesied that in this time that we are living in for him to come out. I know this.
ولكن ما كنت أظنه أن يخرج فيكم معشر العرب.
However, I did not think that he would come out from amongst the Arabs.
ولو علمت أني ألقى لتجشمت لقاءه حتى ألقى.
And if I had the opportunity, if I knew I could meet him, then I would try everything in my ability to meet him.
ولو كنت عنده لغسلت عن قدميه.
And if I was in front of him, I would wash his feet. صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وعلم أنه سيملك ما تحت قدمي هذا.
And then he told them finally, this great king, this great ruler, he told them, know that this man will own the land, this land beneath my own feet.
قال أبو سفيان ثم أوتي بكتاب النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فبرئ.
Then the book, the Quran was brought and then it was read out to them in the gathering.
قال فلما قرئ الكتاب ارتفعت الأصوات فأخرجنا.
And when the Quran was read, was recited, voices were raised and they left.
قال فقلت لأصحابي لقد أمر أمر ابن أبي كبشة يعني عظم شأن محمد يخافه ملك بني الأصفر.
And then Abu Sufyan said, amazing how Muhammad's message now has reached the point where now these great rulers, the yellow people as they call them, have fear of this man who was with us in Mecca.
قال وكنت على يقين أن الله سيظهره.
And I had certainty that Allah سبحانه وتعالى would manifest and bring this faith out.
جاء في رواية ابن شهاب الزهري في صحيح البخاري أن هرقل بعد ذلك جمع خاصته في الشام.
And then in a صحيح حديث narrated by Al-Bukhari, one of the narrators, that he then gathered Hercules, gathered his close people to him.
ودسكر الدساتة أي غلق الأبواب تغليقا شديدا.
And he then closed the doors very tightly.
ثم دعا أصحابه وقال لهم هل لكم في أن يثبت ملككم في الدنيا وتحوزون نعيم الآخرة؟
And he said to them behind his closed doors, do you want to have your kingdom here firm and then you benefit and reap the rewards of the next life?
قالوا نعم بماذا؟
And they told him, yes, how do we do that?
لا تتبعون هذا النبي؟
And he told them very simply, follow this prophet.
قال الراوي فحاصوا حيصة الحمر أي فروا كحمار الوحش إذ يفر من الأسد إلى الأبواب.
And then they began to, upon hearing this, they ran to the doors like an animal running away from a lion that's about to eat it. They ran to the doors, trying to open the doors.
فوجدوها قد أغلقت.
And they found that the doors were already closed.
ثم قال لهم ارجعوا إلي فرجعوا إليه.
And he told them, this emperor said, come back to me.
قال لهم إنما أردت أختبر إيمانكم لا أريد أنكم تدخلوا دينا غير ديننا.
And he then said to them, I was just testing you to see would you leave your faith and enter into this new faith. I'm just testing you.
فرضوا عنه وخروا له ساجدين.
And then they were happy with that and then they prostrated to him.
هذا الحديث يحمل معاني متعددة.
This hadith has many meanings.
من أبرزها يحمل معاني كيف كان يتعامل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع غيره.
From the many meanings, how the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would interact with others.
وكيف عاش أبو سفيان مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر من 53 سنة ما قدر أن يمسك خطأ على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And how that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم lived with Abu Sufyan. Abu Sufyan lived with him for nearly more than 53 years and he could not say anything bad about him.
وقد كان يرجو أبو سفيان في تلك اللحظة أي خطأ على النبي لكي يظهره لكنه ما قدر أن يمسك خطأ على النبي.
And Abu Sufyan, he said he was trying to look for something to say about the Prophet, but he could not think of anything bad to say about him.
وهذا قبل أن يكرمه الله عز وجل بالإسلام.
And this is before Abu Sufyan became Muslim.
وهو بعد تلك الفترة بسنتين أكرمه الله بدين الإسلام.
And then 2 years after this event, he became Muslim.
لكن الشأن الذي نستفيد منه في هذا الأمر كيف نعيش في بلاد المسلمين أو في بلاد غير المسلمين لا يمكن لأحد أن يأخذ عنا أننا نسرق أو أننا نخون أو أننا نكذب أو أننا نخدر.
However, the lesson for us is how do we live amongst Muslims or non-Muslims and they don't accuse us of lying and cheating and treachery and stealing.
لا يمسك أن أحدا أن نخالف شرع الله عز وجل.
And not, nobody can say that we are going against the Sharia, the law of Allah, the sacred law.
أو نخالف ما ندعو إليه من دون الإسلام من شؤون الإسلام.
And we go against the different aspects of Islam.
فإن هذا تعريف حسن بالنبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because this is a good definition, a good introduction into the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أحبابي لا يحتاج منا أن نكذب حتى نعرف به.
And our Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم is not a need of us to lie about him in order for him to be spread around.
ولا أن نغالي في المعاني.
Nor does it require us to exaggerate the meanings.
ولا أن نستجلب في شيء ليس فيه.
And to make meanings that are not present there anyway.
نحن بحاجة إلى أن نعرف بالنبي كما هو.
And we need to tell people the Prophet as he really is.
لكن حتى نعرف به لابد أن نتعرف عليه.
Before we do this, we need to understand and know who he is.
كيف يمكن للواحد منا في اليوم والليلة أن يتعرف إلى رسول الله أكثر؟
How can you and I in the day and the night to know the Prophet more and more?
وأن يتقرب منه بربا أعظم.
And to become a lot more, to have greater closeness to him.
وأن يجتهد في كل يوم وليلة أن ينزل برامج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن حياته.
And how to make the prophetic programming, the schedule, the timetable of our lives according to his prophetic way.
التعرف والتعريف برسول الله أمران متلازمان.
So these two things are connected to each other.
فكلما تعرفت إلى رسول الله عرفت به تلقائيا.
And the more you understand the Prophet, the more you will know the Prophet naturally.
عندنا رجل ياباني جاء يوما من الأيام واشترى شيئا بسيطا من ما نسميها نحن بالبسطة، ولد صغير يبيع أشياء في الشارع.
Yeah. And he mentioned that one day there was a man from Japan. And he came, he was traveling, he came to Yemen, and he passed by a boy on the street, and he had some things that he was selling on the street, some small, simple things.
فرفع النقود وأثناء رفعه للنقود سقطت عدد من مئات الدولارات على الأرض.
And this Japanese man, he wasn't a Muslim, when he took out his money to pay or to buy some things, several $100 fell out of his pocket.
فتبعه الولد الصغير الذي كان معه يمشي خلفه إلى نهاية الشارع يقول له هذه نقودك سقطت منك.
And this small young child, this Muslim child in Yemen, began to follow this Japanese man, and he came with him and said, "This is the money that dropped out of your pocket."
فقال له وقد كان يعرف قليل في العربية قالوا لماذا لم تأخذها؟
And this Japanese man who knew a little bit of Arabic said, "Why did you not take the money?"
قال لأنها حرام.
And he said, because it is something that's haram, prohibited.
مع مرور الأخ إبراهيم مسافيا.
And this was at the same time when a brother Ibrahim, who we know, who came here several times, he was passing by at the time.
قال كيف لي أن أدخل في ديني هذا الولد؟
And this Japanese man said to our friend Ibrahim from Liverpool, he said to him, how can I enter into the religion of this young boy?
فأخذه إبراهيم مسافيا إلى دار المصطفى وشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله.
And he then took him to the school in Yemen, دار المصطفى, and he then testified there's no God but Allah and Muhammad is the messenger.
وآخر جاءنا من بلاد عربية ذات ثراء كبير في المال.
And another story, a man came from a very rich Arab country.
ورأيت الرجل يريد أن يتوطن البلاد وبلادنا فقيرة.
And this man who came from a very wealthy Arab country wanted to reside in Yemen. And Yemen, as you know, isn't as wealthy as all other Arab countries.
قلت له ما سبب أنك تريد أن تجلس في هذه البلاد؟ قال سببها صبي.
And he told them, he said, why? He asked, why do you want to come here and live the life you had before? He said, I want to come to Yemen. The reason why? Because of one little boy.
قلت له كيف ذلك؟ قال خرجت يوما من الأيام اشتهيت ماء فجئت إلى الثلاجة المرتبة في الشارع وكان الجلاس كان الكوب كان مربوط بسلسلة يحتاج مني إذا أردت أن أجلس إلى تكلف.
And he told a story that as in Yemen they have these places of water where you can drink, but and the cup is like connected, it has a string that's connected to the water fountain from which you would drink. And because of the placing of the cup, it's very difficult to drink unless you sit down and crouch.
قال فشربت وأنا قاعد.
And he then this man who didn't feel like bothered to sit down, crouching down, he stood up and just drank it because it's more easier for him.
قال فمر بي صبي وقال عيب عليك رجل بعمة كبير في السن تشرب وأنت قاعد.
And this young boy passed by and said to him, you know, this is shameful on you. How can an old man like you stand and drink?
فقلت هذه البلاد أسكن فيها.
He said, this is the country that I want to reside and live in.
فتعرفون إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في اليوم والليلة هذا الذي يولد تعريفا به تلقائيا.
So knowing the Prophet, this will make us automatically know him even better.
فرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عرف به أصحابه هذا التعريف التلقائي كل يوم يتعرفون من سنته ما يعرفون الناس برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So they then became, they practiced more sunnahs, more aspects of his life, and through that, people then began to understand and to know and to be introduced to the Prophet.
نحن في كل يوم ندخل من البرامج المسهلة للجوالات عندنا المخففة لنا أو البرامج التي تجعلنا نتصل بدون مقابل أو نرسل رسائل بدون مقابل كل يوم ندخل هذه البرامج نحاول نشوف ما الجديد.
And we every day we go into our devices, our mobile phones, for example, and we go into these apps that enable us to phone and to look at to phone different countries for free. And we always look at these things and say, you know, what's anything new on our phones?
لكن نحن بحاجة أكبر وأكثر إلى أن ننزل برامج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في كل يوم.
However, we're more need of programming our lives according to the Prophet's life.
كم نحن بحاجة إلى أن تكون ثيابنا هذه لو نظر إليها كافر يرد قلبه ويحن إلى الإسلام.
And how much need we are in of wearing clothes that are of the Sunnah, so that when people see us, that the non-Muslims, their hearts become softened and they want to enter into Islam.
لأنها ثياب ألبست على ذكر الله.
Because the clothes have been worn at the same time with Allah's name that He mentioned.
وعندما لبسناها أخذنا بسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And when we put these clothes on, we mention the Prophet's name.
وكان مقاصدنا في لبسها مقاصد عالية جاء بها شرع الله.
And our intentions, our aims for wearing these clothes are high and lofty aims that our Sharia has brought for us.
وكم نحن بحاجة إلى أن تكون بيوتنا تدعو إلى الله عز وجل.
And how much more need we are in of our houses to be more reflective of the Prophet's way.
كان رجل عندنا من اليمن لم يخرج بعض الأيام في الدعوة إلى الله عز وجل.
And a man from his country, from Yemen, he would go out to do da'wah, call people to Islam.
فكان إذا خرج في الدعوة يغلق الدكان. قال له بعض أصحابه لماذا تغلق الدكان؟ دع رجلا يقوم مقامه وأنت أخرج.
And he would upon going out to do da'wah, he would close his shop. And a man said to him, why do you close your shop? Put somebody there, and you can, your shop can be open, and you can go.
قال له أريد كما أعرف أنا بدين الإسلام أن دكاني يعرف بدين الإسلام.
He said, just as I want people to know about the religion of Islam, I want my shop also to know about Islam.
قال كيف ذلك؟ قال إذا جاء الناس إلى دكاني وقالوا إنه أغلق لأنه خرج يعرف بدين الإسلام سيصير دكاني يعرف بدين الإسلام. لكن لو كان مفتوحا اشترى الناس منه وذهبوا إلى بيوتهم.
Because so a man said to him, how is your shop calling to Islam? And he said, well, if my shop is closed and people find out that the reason why it's closed is because I have gone to do da'wah and call to Islam, then people know through the shop that I've gone to call people to Islam. How if my shop is open all the time, people will not know that I've gone to call to Islam and my shop will call to Islam.
فالصحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كم عرفوا بدين الإسلام بهذه التلقائية العجيبة.
And how many of the great companions they invite people to Islam through this interesting and amazing way.
كم خرجوا إلى البلدان، بلدان لغات لا يعرفونها، لكن الناس كانوا إذا رأوهم يهتدون.
How many people, these great Sahaba and so forth, they went to many, many lands, foreign lands, who their languages, they cannot understand their languages, but they became Muslim.
وبرًا أسلمت بكمالها لأن الذي خرج فيها رجل يحسن التعريف بالإسلام بلسان الحال وبلسان المدار.
And villages, whole entire villages have become Muslim because one man has gone there and he has a good way. He calls to Islam through his good words and his state, his well-being.
لكن الطمع عندما يأتي غير المسلم ليعرف المسلم بدين الإسلام ويذكره به.
However, the big calamity, the big problem is when you find non-Muslims coming to Muslims and reminding them and telling them who they are.
قال بعض السائقين الذين يسوقون السواح.
One of these tourist agents who takes tourists around.
قال إن مما أستحي منه كثيراً أحياناً السائح الذي عندي يقول لي للمسلم no problem, لا في صلاة ما في مشكلة عندنا. لو تريد تخرج تصلي ما في مشكلة.
This tourist manager, he would take, he's Muslim, he would have his tourist company taking non-Muslims with him. And he said from the deeply embarrassing situation is when one of the non-Muslim tourists would say to him several times, look, if you want to pray, there's no problem with us, you can go and pray.
وأحياناً قال أتحدث مع هذا الرجل فيؤذن المؤذن فيقول سوري ممكن تجيب المؤذن أنا أتكلم قال وهو يقول لي أنا ممكن تجيب المؤذن ما في مشكلة عندي.
And one of the other embarrassing situations, he also said this tourist agent who's Muslim, he said that when the adhan will be going off and this non-Muslim person will say to him, look, because he's talking to him, he said, look, you don't have to talk to me and you can answer the prayer.
هذا يكون قام عندما غير المسلم يعرف المسلم بدينه.
This is a calamity when we find non-Muslims clarifying and calling us to our religion.
وبعظمة ما عنده.
And to the greatness of what this person has with him.
أو يذكره بمنكر نبع فيه.
Or to remind him of something bad that he's doing.
فيقول له أليس دينك يأمر بهذا؟ أليس دينك ينهى عن هذا؟
Like for example, a non-Muslim says, doesn't your religion say to do this? Doesn't your religion say not to do that?
فهو بدل أن يعرف بدينه صار يعرفه هو بدينه.
And he said, instead of this man clarifying, being an example of his religion, he then becomes a person by which the religion is judged.
قال بعضهم إذا كنت لا تقدر أن تحمل هم الدعوة إلى الله فلا تحمل الدعوة همك. يعني إذا كنت ما تقدر تشتغل أنت بالدعوة إلى الله لا تشغل الدعوة بك. استقم على الأقل في ذاتك.
And he said, if you're not going to do da'wah properly, calling people to Islam properly, if you're not going to do that, then don't let the da'wah be busy with you.
سمع يا رجل أن المسلمين الرجال مبادئ يثبتون عليه.
Hercules heard that the Muslims were people of foundation, of principle, which they stood to.
فقال يوما لجماعة منهم إذا مسكتم جماعة من المسلمين فضوا عليهم لا تقتلوا أحدا منهم أريد أن أختبرهم.
And he then one day he said to his people, if you ever capture any Muslims, don't kill them straight away. Bring them to me so I can interrogate them.
ف فخرج سيدنا عبد الله بن حذافة في طليعة من الصحابة ومن التابعين يمشون في بعض الجوانب فمسكوا من قبل جنود هرقل.
عبد الله بن حذافة was then he was going out with a group of Muslims, صحابة and تابعين, and they were captured by the soldiers of Hercules.
فلما جاءوا بهم إلى هرقل قال استبوهم لا تقتلوهم.
And when they were brought to Hercules, Hercules ordered them not to be killed.
اسجنوهم كلهم في سجن واحد واسجنوا أميرهم في سجن مستقل.
And he ordered that all of them were to be thrown into one prison and the leader would be to be placed in prison in a separate cell.
يعني ثم أبقى سيدنا عبد الله بن حذافة ثلاثة أيام بلا ماء ولا أكل.
And he عبد الله بن حذافة was in a cell for 3 days, no food and no water.
ثم قال لهم أدخلوا عليه لحم خنزير وشراب الخمر.
And after 3 days of no food, no water, he was hungry. He was Hercules ordered that alcohol and some pork was to be placed into his cell.
فتركوه عنده يوما كاملا لم يلمس منه شيئا.
And this alcohol, this pork was in his cell for a whole day and he didn't touch it once.
فلم فاستدعاه هرقل وقال له لك 3 أيام لم تأكل ولم تشرب قال نعم.
And Hercules then called him and he told him you for 3 days have not ate or drank anything and he said yes.
قال ثم قدمت لك لحم الخنزير وشراب الخمر لماذا لا تأكل.
And he then said I have given you pork and alcohol why have not eaten anything from or drank anything.
أليس دينك يبيح هذا للمضطر.
And he then told them, doesn't your religion allow you to do this in drastic situations?
قال له عبد الله نعم إني كنت جائعا وعطشانا وأعرف أن ديني يبيح هذا.
And he then